history. This is from my book, from The Mind of the Jesuit. I cited this. Quotes, consult the page of history. Wherever priests have established colleges, they have aspired to direct and to govern. Rather than allow their power to be diminished, they would suffer kings and nations to perish, and the whole world to be reduced to ruin. And their fate is such that they fall not but when empires fall, while kings are always crushed and annihilated beneath the thrones of their own successors. Behold, O my son, that beautiful land of Egypt. At some future time, your own unfortunate country will exhibit the same melancholy spectacle to the stranger who may be induced by curiosity to explore its interior. Instead of those splendid cities where encouragement and culture promoted virtue, courage, science, industry, and art, will be seen only temples and palaces in ruins. Columns and capitals tumble to the ground, and at every step those mournful monuments will attest amidst those famed remains the power of the priest and the wretchedness of the people who were their prey. End quote. Polish aristocrat, Polish-born Jesuit Father Seville, from Arnaud's wonderful work, citing all these various Jesuits speaking. A very valuable work when you compare what's in there to the scripture and what they say to what the Bible says. We must compare what men say to what the Bible says. And what the Bible says must come first.
Yeah.
All other considerations must be put aside. Must be. Or surely we will make shipwreck, if not of the faith, certainly of a good conscience towards God and towards man. Now, Genesis 47:14. The famine is sore in the land. The people have eaten up all their food. They've eaten up all their bread. And Joseph gathered up all the money that was found in the land of Egypt. Let me stop there. That's already happened here. You don't have any money in your pocket. You've got scrip in your pocket. You've got notes. You don't have what's biblically defined as money. But Joseph gathered up all the money that was found in the land of Egypt. Silver being the common currency, and I'm sure gold was in circulation in some level as well. He gathered up all the money that was found in the land of Egypt, and what? In the land of Canaan. For the corn which they bought, and Joseph brought the money into Pharaoh's house. The king, the despot, the absolute dictator, had control of all gold and silver.